Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the next chapter of chemistry. Is matter around us pure? Chapter number 2. Is matter around us pure? You all know what is matter. Anything that occupies space and has mass is known as matter. And matter is made up of particles. Now, what are the characteristics of particles of matter? What are the characteristics of particles of matter? Yes, Shrethapan. Okay, Kashish, roll number 31. Kashish, roll number 31, light blue. What are the characteristics of particles of matter?
First characteristic is that particles of matter are continuously moving. They are having space between them. They are having force of attraction between them.
Right. First, particles of matter have spaces between them. Second, particles of matter are continuously moving. Third, particles of matter attract each other. ये तो हमने सब कर लिया चैप्टर नंबर 1 में. नाउ चैप्टर नंबर 2 इज मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर. हाउ डू वी जज वेदर द मिल्क घी बटर सॉल्ट मिनरल वाटर और जूस दैट वी बाय फ्रॉम मार्केट आर प्योर. हाउ डू वी जज वेदर द मिल्क घी बटर सॉल्ट मिनरल वाटर जूस आर प्योर that we buy from the market. Yes.
Then we can check that whether they are pure from the coverings in which they write, the companies write the proteins, minerals or whatever nutrients are present at the back side of the covering.
Narinder
Virdhi. There's actually the different methods to check if we have to.
Yes, Narinder Virdhi, roll number 36. How do we judge the milk, ghee, butter, mineral water or juice that we buy from the market are pure?
Yes. Oh, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Ma'am, we can judge them or when we taste them, when there is like, we feel the difference between the taste, like from the normal taste, we can say that sometimes they are adulterated and they are not pure.
Okay. Then Himanshi Prabhakar, row number 12.
We can check that whether they are pure or not by the mixing them with other materials.
Okay, Pratham Kumar, roll number 33. Pratham Kumar, roll number 33.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Pratham. Anji.
Ma'am, we can judge anything that it's pure by its particles of matter, which is made up of, means the things which are put in it, the things which is used to make that thing. Constituent particles of matter.
Okay, Kashish ji, aap bataiye. Kashish,
yes,
yes,
Kashish. For example, we have to check that whether milk is pure or not. We just make the cheese of it. If it is like good in taste, then it means the milk is pure. If not, then milk is not pure. It is adulterated or something else.
Pure ghee, pure milk, shuddh desi ghee. Hai na? Aise likha hota na labels ke upar, packets ke upar likha hota na ye. To aap kahoge ki ma'am agar packets ke upar likha hai, to ye pure hai. So have you ever noticed the word pure written on the packs of these food items? For common person, pure means having no adulteration. कोई मिलावट नहीं है, तो ये pure है. अब घी के ऊपर लिखा है pure घी, तो मैंने उसमें कोई मिलावट नहीं है, तो आप कहोगे कि pure है, ठीक है ना? For a common person, pure means having no adulteration. For the scientist, all these things are the mixtures of different substances. It means वो pure नहीं है. अगर शुद्ध देसी घी लिखा है तो तो ये आम पर्सन के लिए, कॉमन पर्सन के लिए तो ये प्योर है क्योंकि इसमें कोई मिलावट नहीं है. लेकिन साइंस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से सोचे तो फॉर साइंटिस्ट ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर द मिक्सचर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट सब्सटेंसेस एंड हेंस नॉट प्योर. क्लियर? फॉर एग्जाम्पल मिल्क. मिल्क इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ वॉटर, फैट्स एंड प्रोटीन्स. मिल्क इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ वॉटर, फैट्स एंड प्रोटीन्स. तो ये साइंस में हम इसको कहेंगे कि प्योर नहीं है. अब साइंस के अकॉर्डिंगली प्योर है क्या? When a scientist say that something is pure, it means all the particles of that substance are same in their chemical nature. अगर साइंटिस्ट किस चीज को प्योर कह रहे हैं, मीन्स उसमें जितने भी पार्टिकल्स हैं वो क्या होंगे? सेम होंगे. द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ दैट मैटर आर सेम इन देयर केमिकल नेचर. और आप एग्जाम्पल आप कह रहे हो कि वॉटर, प्योर वॉटर. प्योर वॉटर मीन्स सिर्फ उसकी में वॉटर के ही मॉलिक्यूल्स हैं. H2O और कुछ नहीं है. राइट? When a scientist says something is pure, it means all the particles of that substance are pure in their chemical nature. A pure substance consists of single type of particles. A pure substance consists of single type of particles. अगर आप कहते pure gold, that means उसमें सिर्फ gold के ही particles हैं. What do you mean by pure substance? Pure substance means single type of particles. Pure substance consists of single type of particle. It means a substance is the pure single form of matter. Pure substance classified as elements and compounds. First, elements. The Robert Boyle was the first scientist to use the term element. Robert Boyle was the first scientist to use the term element in 1661. An element is pure substance that contains only one kind of atoms. This word atom is given by Greek philosopher Democritus. He said, if we go on dividing matter, a stage will come when the particles obtained cannot be divided further, and he called these indivisible particles atom. Okay, now an element is pure substance that contain only one kind of atoms. For example, iron. Iron is made up of only one kind of atoms, means iron atoms. Therefore, iron kya hai? Therefore, iron is an element. Similarly, silver. Silver is made up of only one kind of atom, means silver atoms. Therefore, silver is an element. An element is pure substance that contain only one kind of atoms. For example, iron element. For example, silver element. Okay? An element is made up of only one kind of atom, which are identical in all respect in size and mass. Iron element is made up of iron atoms. Iron is made up of only one kind of atoms, means iron atoms. अब जो iron atoms हैं, iron element में, उन सबका size और mass क्या होगा? Same. Similarly, silver में जो silver के atoms हैं, silver is an element which contain silver atoms. वो भी क्या होंगे? Same in size and mass. But the atoms of different element यहाँ पे हमने लिखे हैं iron and silver. अब आयरन के जो एटम्स होंगे वो सिल्वर के एटम से क्या होंगे? डिफरेंट होंगे. एटम्स ऑफ डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स डिफर इन साइज एंड मास. आयरन के जो एटम का साइज होगा वो डिफरेंट होगा किससे? सिल्वर के एटम से. और जो आयरन के एटम का मास होगा
वो सिल्वर के एटम से क्या होगा, डिफरेंट, राइट? एटम्स ऑफ डिफरेंट एलिमेंट डिफर इन साइज एंड मास. एलिमेंट्स आर फाउंड टू एग्जिस्ट इन थ्री स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर, दैट इज सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैस. नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स नोन एट प्रेजेंट आर मोर देन 100, एंड 92 एलिमेंट्स आर नेचुरली अक्रिंग एंड रेस्ट आर मैन मेड. Majority of elements are solid. Now, solid elements, for example, iron, copper, aluminium, silver, gold, sodium, potassium, sulfur, phosphorus, and carbon. Okay. So, liquid elements, mercury and bromine. Mercury and bromine are liquid element. Right. Elements gallium and cesium become liquid at a temperature slightly above room temperature. Gallium and cesium become liquid at room temperature slightly above room temperature, that is at 303 Kelvin. Okay. Now 11 elements are in gaseous state at room temperature. For example, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, fluorine, chlorine, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon. Okay. Then on the basis of physical properties, elements have been divided into three types: metals, non-metals, and metalloids. Metals, non-metals, and metalloids. Now, physical properties of metals. First, metals are malleable. Metals are malleable. Means metals can be hammered or beaten to form thin sheets without breaking, and all the metals are not equally malleable. Some are more malleable than others. For example, gold and silver are the most malleable metal. Aluminium, copper, iron are also highly malleable metals. Some metals can be beaten into very, very thin sheets known as foil. And you all know ki silver foil is used for decorating sweets. And aluminium foils are used for wrapping medicines, food items like biscuits, chocolates. And the sheets of iron, copper, aluminium are used for making utensils. Next, metals are ductile. Means metals can be stretched into thin wire. Metals can be stretched into thin wires. All metals are not equally ductile. Gold and silver are the most ductile metal. Gold and silver are the most ductile metals. Next, metals are good conductor of heat and electricity. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Next, metals are lustrous. Metals have shining surface when freshly prepared. This property of shining surface of metal is known as metallic luster. For example, silver has shining white surface, gold is yellow, copper is reddish brown. Metals are hard. Sodium and potassium are soft metals. Sodium and potassium are soft metal and can be easily cut with knife. Can be easily cut with knife. Okay. Sodium and potassium are soft metal and can be cut with the knife. Next, metals have high tensile strength. High tensile strength means metals can hold the large weight without breaking. Due to this, it is used for constructions of building, bridges and railway line, etc. Then next, metals are solid at room temperature. Metals are solid at room temperature. Exception, mercury. Mercury is liquid at room temperature. Next, metals have high melting and boiling point. Okay, जो sodium and potassium है वो क्या है? Soft metal. Therefore, sodium and potassium have low melting point. Next, metals make sound when hit. Due to this, metals are used for making bells and wires of guitar, sitar or tanpura. Now, what are the various properties of metals? First, metals are malleable. Next, metals are ductile. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals are lustrous. Metals are hard. Lekin sodium and potassium are soft metal and can be cut with a knife. Next, metals are metals have high tensile strength. Next, metals are solid at room temperature, exception mercury. Mercury is liquid at room temperature. Metals have high melting and boiling point, and metal makes sound when hit. Note down all these physical properties of metal. Next, physical properties of non-metals. Non-metals are not malleable. Non-metals are not ductile. Non-metals are poor conductor of heat and electricity. Non-metals are not lustrous. But iodine is a non-metal which is lustrous. Iodine. Is a lustrous non-metal. Non-metals may be solid, liquid or gases at room temperature. So these are the physical properties of non-metal. Non-metals are not malleable, not ductile, poor conductor of heat and electricity. Non-metals are non-lustrous, but iodine is lustrous non-metal. Non-metals may be solid, liquid or gases at room temperature. Some elements have intermediate properties between those of metals and non-metals. They are called metalloids. Some elements have intermediate properties between those of metals and non-metals. They are called metalloids. For example, boron, silicon, germanium.